Hello everyone, and welcome back to this brand new video. So, is the stop loss value we've chosen too wide? Does using a take profit or a break even improve our strategy? Well, one of the coaches at Unger Academy here, and today we're going to be looking at how we can answer these questions using two perhaps little known metrics. I'm talking about the MAE and the MFE metrics. So we're going to be discussing them in depth to understand how we can use them to improve our exits. Before we begin, though, as always, I invite you to please subscribe to our channel, click on the notification bell, and leave us a like to this video. Thank you so much. Hi, we are the Unger Academy, and we teach traders how to make money in the markets. Our founder, Andrea Unger, had been struggling with trading for years until he developed his automated trading method, which he used to become the only four-time world trading champion. Subscribe to our channel for free tips and tricks. Okay, so let's first try understanding what MAE and MFE are. So let's start with MAE, the maximum adverse excursion. Let's take one of our trades with its entry and exit price and give the lowest value recorded by the market. Here the MAE quantifies the maximum drawdown of our trade numerically. So let's take its sibling, the MFE, which is the maximum favorable excursion. And let's take the trade that we have just seen and see the highest value reached by the market. The MFE simply quantifies the maximum profit that the trade made before it ended. Now, if we understand correctly what these two values represent, it's clear that stop loss and take profit can be seen as, well, borderline cases. What I mean by that is that the monetary value of the stop loss coincides with the MAE of the trade closed by the stop. And similarly, the monetary value of the take profit coincides with the MFE of the trade closed in the target. But why is it helpful to know how to use these metrics? Well, in a nutshell, we can say that if we were to extend this analysis to all the trades made by our strategy, we could better understand whether our stop loss, take profit, or break even orders are placed at the right level. In addition, the high values of these two metrics should also lead us to understand the reasons behind them and potentially adjust our exit levels. We'll see a practical example in a moment to better understand how we can do this, but first, let's move on to our MultiCharts platform and take a look at where these metrics are displayed and at how we can read them in an easy way. Now, this is the chart of crude oil. We're using a 15-minute time frame, and we've applied a strategy to it, a strategy that we'll need for our tests shortly. And in our report under trade analysis, we can see that we have percentage metrics. We'll ignore those and just focus on the absolute metrics. Now, we notice that we have two separate charts, one for each metric, and these charts are scatter plots. But how do we read these charts? Well, first of all, we can see that there are green and red dots in both charts. These green and red dots represent, respectively, the profit and loss trades of our strategy. In the case of the MAE, we find on the y-axis the profit and loss of our trades, and on the x-axis, the maximum drawdown achieved. In the case of the MFE, we find on the y-axis the profit and loss of our trades, while on the x-axis, we find the maximum run-up. So let's just take some points as an example. This one had a maximum drawdown of about $1,000, and then it closed with a profit of about $1,700. With the MFE, the reading is similar, but the parameter changes. Here's an example. The price went up by about $3,500. Then it went down and closed at about $1,200. Let's just go and take our example strategy. Let's look at what our inputs are. The stop loss is $1,400. The take profit is $4,000. And we have no break even. Let's just keep these values in mind, and then we'll need them. Okay. Let's also take a look at the metrics of the strategy. It generates $247,000 with a maximum loss of $18,000. The average trade is $210, making about 1,200 trades, balanced between long and short. And this is the current equity. Now, see where you can find stop loss and take profit on our charts. We're on the MFE chart. Find the stops that are aligned at the $1,400 level. Now, they're more concentrated here on the left side, which is natural. If we think about it, they reach limit run-ups before they're closed on stops. We also find some unpleasant trades for the trader. These have achieved substantial run-ups before they're closed on stops. We find a positive outlier here in the upper right-hand corner and 3 to 4 negative outliers that, for various reasons, have exceeded the value set by our stop. Finally, behind this point, all the targets in our strategy are at $4,000. Now, if we switch to the MAE chart, we also find all of the strategy's profit targets are aligned at a value of $4,000. Again, we notice the positive outlier here at the top and the negative outliers here on the right. So where's the stop loss? Well, they're all here below the $1,400 level. All right, guys, but now that we know how to read these metrics, well, what can we do with them? How can we use them to help us make better trading decisions and improve our strategies? Well, let's go and resume our strategy for crude oil. We know we have a stop loss at $1,400. This is a final value because it was optimized a few years ago. However, we intentionally changed the stop loss by setting a much larger value, 3 times as much, $4,200. And we do this to see if, for example, the MAE analysis tells us that we're somehow exaggerating. So here's our chart. It's immediately noticeable that we have a lot of losing trades to the right of this value, around $1,500. And so we can tell right away that something's wrong. Let's take a look at the numerical metrics of the system. Net profit has dropped to $212,000. And the maximum drawdown has risen sharply to over $40,000. The average trade has also been negatively affected by our trade, and equity is certainly not what it was before. But if we go back to our MAE chart, we could say that limiting trades to the right of a specific value, let's say with a drawdown of around $1,500, it would benefit our system. Right? And so this means that the graphical analysis, that's already told us at a glance that we should have reduced the value of our stop loss. Then to calculate the optimal and stable value of the stop, the numerical optimization of multi-charts, well, that will undoubtedly help us. Now, when does the MFE come into play? Remember that the original strategy had a target of $4,000. I've purposefully set it here at the double value of $8,000 to see if our chart indicates anything. We can see that to the right of the run-up value of $4,000, we do have trades that close at a higher profit. But we also have trades that declined by about the same amount and closed at a gain of less than $4,000. Let's take a look at whether the numerical metrics of our system confirm what we've said. So we can see that the net profit has remained more or less the same. The maximum drawdown has also deteriorated a little bit. The average trade is at the initial value. Equity isn't very different from the original. So the metrics confirm that there hasn't been much improvement, maybe even a slight deterioration. And actually, the MFE chart also shows us that setting a too tight take profit would jeopardize promising trades, forcing them to close at a value that is definitely too low. And we understand this by looking at the number of profitable trades to the right of the maximum run-up of $2,000. Almost all the winning trades were made with a gain of more than $2,000. So setting a take profit around the $2,000 mark would mean that we would leave all of those additional profits on the plate, and that's certainly not something that we would be happy with. So I set a profit target of $2,000. Let's now see if the numerical metrics of the system confirm what we suspected. We find that the net profit has dropped to $175. The maximum drawdown, well, that's remained about the same as before. However, the average trade has dropped to a value of $141. And this confirms that setting a take profit too tightly brought about a significant deterioration in the system. Another way to use the MFE is to check at a glance the potential effectiveness of adding a break-even exit to our strategy. The break-even value must be set between the value of zero and the value of our strategy's target. However, we can see that there are only a few losing trades to the right of this range, so we don't expect to get any, significant changes by introducing a break-even stop. But let's take a look at the optimization on multi-charts to confirm what we've said. we find that adding a break-even at any value doesn't change the metrics, the net profit, the average trade, or even the maximum drawdown. As is often the case, introducing a break-even doesn't change the system's results much. Still, it can be psychologically helpful because it limits retracements, making a strategy more tolerable. So guys, we've seen the MAE and the MFE metrics, how we can read them in a simple and straightforward way, and how we can use them to decide on the exit values that we use in our strategies. If there is anyone among you who is interested in the world of systematic trading, I recommend that you go and click on the link in the description of this video. From there, you can watch a video of Andrea Unger, or you can get our best-selling book by just covering the shipping costs, and even, hey, go book a free call with a member of our team. If you enjoyed this video, please leave us a like, subscribe to our channel, and go and click on that notification bell, you know the one, so that you can stay updated on the release of all our new content. Thank you so much for your time and attention, and we look forward to seeing you again soon.